Hi friends, welcome back. In the previous session, we have discussed matrix multiplication, properties of matrix multiplication, and based on properties, the questions are likely to be asked for 5 marks, I told. We have discussed one such problem, proving the associativity of a matrix multiplication. Today, we shall continue with the next example. But before that, okay, just I have remembered the question which has been found in competitive examination. The question is like this. Find the order of, I'll just give you the general question, like, find the order of x, a, b, c, d. Clearly that x is a product of 4 matrices, a, b, c, d. A is a matrix of order m cross n. B is a matrix of order n cross p. C is a matrix of order p cross q. And D is a matrix of order Q cross R. I'm sure that all of you can recall that, okay, in the previous class I have told the condition for matrix multiplication, number of columns of first matrix is equal to the number of rows of second matrix. And that will satisfy all the 4 matrices in this product, matrix multiplication. The question is, find the order of X. So actually, to answer such question, you should not take much time. It can be answered within few seconds, maybe 5 seconds. Only check the number of rows of first matrix and the number of columns of last matrix. Therefore, the order of X would be M cross R. Suppose if A is a matrix of order 3 cross 2, B is a matrix of order 2 cross 5, C is a matrix of order 5 cross 1, and D is a matrix of order 1 cross 4. What would be the order of X then? It will be 3 cross 4. Okay, that is very simple. So we shall continue with the 5 mark questions then. The question which is asked many a times, maybe 3 board examination question paper, the question is as follows. Second question. Let A, I take the order of that matrix A is 3 cross 3 with the elements 0, 6, 7. And let me take a second row, it is minus 6, 0, 8. And third row, let it be 7, minus 8, 0. And let me take another matrix of order same, 3 cross 3, B, with the entries, with the elements 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 2. And let the last row be 1, 2, 0. Let me take C, a column matrix. 1 cross 3, 3 cross 1 I'll take with the entries 2, minus 2, 3. The question which is asked, find AC, BC. So then A plus B into C. You're asked to find these three and also verify A plus B into C is equal to AC plus BC. You're asked to find the required terms first, okay? So let me first write, in order to find all this, first let me find what is the this expression. First let me find what is A plus B. Marks will be allotted step by step. Like A plus B, you have already studied matrix addition. While adding 2 matrices, you need to take care that matrix order must be same. Order of both the matrices must be same. And that is true, 3 cross 3. So I'll directly add them. What is 0 plus 0? That is 0. I need not explain much about how to add 2 matrices. Or else, okay, you may write here 0, 6, 7, minus 6, 0, 8, 7, minus 8, 0. In order to avoid confusion here, I'll write. This is A and B is 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 2, 1, 2, 0. Adding the corresponding elements, what do you expect here? 0 plus 0, 0. Then 6 plus 1, 7. 7 plus 1 is 8. We have minus 6 plus 1 is minus 5. We have 0 plus 0, 0. Then 8 plus 2, 10. Next we have here 7 plus 1, 8. It is minus 8 plus 2, minus 6. Then we have 0 plus 0, 0. So this is nothing but A plus B matrix. For evaluating this one, you will be given 1 mark. Okay, next let me continue with A plus B into C. Let me repeat once again. So just okay, let me write A plus B, 0, 7, 8, minus 5, 0, 10. It is 8 minus 6, 0. Need to be multiplied with C, where C is nothing but a column matrix. 2 minus 2, 3. You are supposed to take the rows of first matrix to find the product. Multiply the rows of first matrix with the columns of second matrix. You please recall it. What do you expect here? First one is 0 into 2, it is 0, minus 14, it is 0 minus 14, 8 threes are 24. Next, okay, is second row with the first column is the second row first column position. It is minus 5 into 2, it is minus 10. 0 into anything, it is 0. 10 into 3, it is 30. Okay, next, third row with the first column, third row first column position, it is 16 plus 12 plus 0. So what do you expect here? The first element is 10. Second element, it is 30 minus 10. Next is 16 plus 12, 28. So this will carry 1 mark. Then I continue with finding B into C. B into C. B is nothing but second matrix. Or you may find AC first. Okay, just first AC. A into C, A is nothing but 0, 6, 7, minus 6, 0, 8, 7, minus 8, 0, into C is nothing but 2, minus 2, 3. Multiply rows of first matrix with the columns of second matrix. We expect here 0, it is 0 only. Next, 6 into it is minus 2, it is minus 12. 7 into 3, it is 21. Next one, it is minus 12. Next, 0. Next, 24. I hope all of you cope up with. What's the next 7 twos are? Next, minus into minus, 0. We expect A into C, it is 9. This one is 12, and this will be 30. So that is AC. Okay, so next, I'll evaluate what is B into C. B, C. This will carry 1 mark. First, let me write B. It is 0, 1, 1. It is 1, 0, 2. 1, 2, 0. Into C, it is 2 minus 2, 3. Multiply rows with the columns. So we expect here, minus 2, first is 0, minus 2 plus 6. Next, second is 2 plus 0 plus 6. Next we expect here, it is 2 minus 4 plus 0. So, and this would be, first element is 4, 6 minus 2, it is 4, we have done some mistake here it seems. First is 0, second is minus 2, and third one is plus 3, okay, I did the mistake here, 3 minus 2, it is 1. Next, okay, we have it is 8. Next, it is minus 2. This also will carry 1 mark. you have AC, you have BC. Evaluate what is AC plus BC. AC plus BC. What is AC? It is 9, 12, 13. Plus BC. What is BC? It is 1, 8, minus 2. So what do you expect on adding these? It is 9 plus 1, 10. 12 plus 8, it is 20. What is 30 minus 2? It is 28. I'll take this as equation 1. I'll take this as equation 2. Equation 1 indicates the value of A plus B into C, and the equation 2 gives you AC plus BC. They were just by 1 and 2. By 1 and 2, what do you have? A plus B into C will be equal to AC plus BC. AC plus BC. So that is the solution. Okay, so I hope all of you understood this. So, but here, little calculation is there, and I told you the mark distribution in board examination. This will carry 1 mark, 2, 3, 4 here. Evaluating this one, BC 1 mark, 4, and then verifying the final answer, 1 mark. So we shall continue with the next problem. Question number 3. So that is likely to be asked for 3 marks. The problem is like this. There is a 3 cross 3 matrix given. Say f of x consisting of trigonometric terms, the function, a functional matrix, a matrix with the functions which consists of trigonometric terms, I call 3 cross 3 matrix, cos x minus sin x 0, sin x, cos x, 0, 0, 0, 1. So this question is found even in competitive examination. Similar, it may be 2 cross 2 restricted to only just 2 rows and 2 columns. F of x is given. You are asked to show. F of x into f of y is equal to f of x plus y. F of x into f of y, it is f of x plus y. Here normally we make use of the trigonometric compound angle formula. So can you recall the trigonometric compound angle formula? One derivation of 5 mark which has found in first PO syllabus, cos of x plus y. Can you recall that formula? It is cos x cos y minus sin x sin y. So that will be applicable here. You know that f of x being given, what would be f of y? What will be f of y? F of y will be, we have to replace x in terms of y now. We expect here cos y minus cos y, minus sin y, 0, sin y, cos y, 0, 0, 0, 1. Even, if you need to find what is f of theta, what is f of theta? It will be cos theta minus sin theta, 0, sin theta, cos theta, 0, 0, 0, 1. Like that. Or what is f of chocolate? It will be cos chocolate minus sin chocolate, like that. Okay. You have f of y is, f of x is there. We have to find the product of them. What is f of x into f of y? F of x, it is nothing but what? Cos x minus sin x, 0. Sin x, cos x, 0. 0, 0, 1. It has to be multiplied with the another, f of y, it is cos y minus sin y, 0. Sin y, cos y, 0. 0, 0, 1. We are supposed to multiply rows of first matrix with the columns of second matrix. What do you expect then? Let's check. Cos x has to be multiplied with cos y. We get cos x into cos y. Cos x, cos y. Then second element with this second element, it is negative actually, minus sin x, sin y. That is the first element. First row with the first column gives you first entry. Next, first row with the second column, check. What is this into this one? It is minus sin y cos x. Then this with this one, it is once also once again minus. I can take minus outside, then it becomes plus. It will be sin x cos y. Last element will be 0. This will be 0. Okay, similarly, what do you expect here? This will be just okay. This into this one, you can observe here 0, minus 0, plus 0, that will be 0 only. Okay, what is second row with the first column? It is sin x cos y. And then this with this one, it is cos x sin y, plus cos x sin y. Next, this into this one, it is negative sin x sin y plus cos x cos y. The last one, this into this, will be 0. Okay, what is this into this one? It is 0 plus 0 plus 0, that is 0. What is this into this one? It is 0 plus 0 plus 0. So next one, what is this into this one? It is 0 plus 0 plus 1. It is 1. Just check here. What is cos A cos B minus sin A sin B? It is cos of A plus B. In the place of A and B, we have X and Y. Therefore, you expect it is cos of X plus Y. And here negative is taken outside. It is sin X cos Y plus cos X sin Y. You are aware of compound angle formula, sin A cos B plus cos A sin B, it is sin of A plus B, but minus sin of X plus Y. And here 0. Next entry here, this will be same as this one, but positive. It is positive sin of X plus Y. And this will be same as this one, just check here, it is cos X cos Y minus sin X sin Y, it is cos of X plus Y. And here 0. We have 0, 0, 1. Now compare this with this one. What do you observe here? In the place of x, we have x plus y. Therefore, no doubt, this should be f of x plus y. So I may begin like this. Okay, just left hand side. This is equal to right hand side. So this is how we can solve it. And this question is normally found for 3 marks in board examination. Okay, we shall continue with another question of 5 marks, which is likely to be asked. A matrix of order 3 cross 3 is given. Show that there is an equation, cubic equation of matrix satisfy a particular equation. There may be 3 or 4 problems in the NCERT book, but I will explain only one of them. The rest of the problems you please practice at home. So the question is like this. Okay, question number 4. A is equal to, if A is a matrix of order 3 cross 3, I'll take with the simple elements given in the NCERT book. 1, 0, 2. Second row I'll take here 0, 2, 1. Third row, let it be 2, 0, 3. This is a matrix of order 3 cross 3 given. You are asked to prove that or show that A cube minus 6A square plus 7A plus something into identity, it is 2i, is equal to a null matrix, plus 2i is a null matrix. How to prove this? A is given. We have to prove this. This is a little lengthy because we have to evaluate A cube means. Please do not write A square as by squaring these elements. Sometimes you do that mistake. It is absolutely wrong. First, let me explain what is A square. A square is not, it's 1, 0, 4, square madudala. Elements should not be squared. A square means it is A into A. It's known to everyone. A square means A into A. Means you have to multiply the two matrices like 1, 0, 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 0, 3. Same matrices must be multiplied, okay? A into A. 1, 0, 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 0, 3. When you practice yourself, you just check the timings also, how much time you require to complete it. So let me reduce the steps here by just telling it orally. First one, first row with the first column gives you only one element, first row, first column element. 1 ones are 1, this will be 0, this is 4. Therefore, we have first element is 5. I hope you understand. Suppose if you have difficulty, let me write 1 plus 0 plus 4, no problem. Now, what is first row with the second column? This is 0, 0, 0. 0 plus 0 plus 0. Don't write three zeros, okay? It is 0 only. What is the first row with the third column? It is 2 plus 0 plus 6. 2 plus 0 plus 6. Okay, what is the next one? It is second row with the first column. It is 0 plus 0 plus 2. 0 plus 0 plus 2. Okay, next, this with this one also gives you what? 0 plus this into this one. It is 0 plus 4 plus 0. Second row with the third column. It is 0 plus 2 plus 3. Next, okay, what is third row with the first column? Here it should be placed. Third row with the first column means it is 2 plus 0 plus 6. Next, this into this one means it is 0 plus 0 plus 0. The last one, it is 4, this with this one, 4 plus 0 plus 9. Now write the final simplified matrix. It is 5, 0, 8. Next it is 2, 4, 5, 8, 0, 13. So that is a matrix representing A square. Okay, next, in order to find A cube, we have to multiply A square by A. A square into A gives you A cube. So let me write A square as it is. It is 5, 0, 8. It is 2, 4, 5. 8, 0, 13 has to be multiplied with A, means 1, 0, 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 0, 3. Rows of first matrix has to be multiplied with the columns of second matrix. We expect the elements are first row here, 5, first row with the first column, 5 plus 0 plus 16. Next, second, first row with the second column, it is 0 plus 0 plus 0. Next one, first row with the third column, it is 10 plus 0 plus 24. Second row with the first column, it is 2 plus 0 plus 10. Next, okay, second row with the second column, it is 0 plus 8 plus 0. Second row with the third column, it is 4 plus 4 plus 15. Next one is the third row with the first column, it is 8 plus 0 plus 26. Okay, next, this with this one means 0 plus 0 plus 0. Last row with the last column, it is 16 plus 0 plus 39. Okay, so what this gives? It is a cube. A cube is nothing but what is that? 5 plus 16, it is 21. And this will be 0. And here we have 34. Okay, so next it is 12. Here's 8. This one is 8 plus 15, it is 23. Next here we have it's 34. 0. And what is 16 plus 39? 16 plus 39 will be 55. So that is a cube. Then okay, just in order to prove that LHS is equal to RHS, I begin with LHS. What is LHS? It is a cube minus 6a square plus 7a plus 2y. So what you may do, just you can evaluate what is minus 6 into a square separate and 7 into a, 2 into I, you can operate them separately and then add finally. Not required here. I'll first write a cube. A cube is nothing but 21, 0, 34, 12, 8, 23. It is 34, 0, 55. Then minus 6 into, let me try right here, minus 6, I'll take it outside. Into a square, just check that a square, it is 5, 0, 8, 2, 4, 5, 8, 0, 13. Then next we have here plus 7 into a, it is plus 7 into a, the given matrix, it is 1, 0, 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 0, 3. It's a given matrix. Okay, what do you get on adding them? Just okay, evaluate now. Simplify. Your first one is 21. Need to be added with minus 30 because 6 5s are 30. Then plus 7. So here we have 21 first element it is so just okay I missed one term, it is 2 into I, 2 into I is missed. Okay, what is identity matrix? 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 1, that is missing here. But just what do you expect here? Plus 2, 2 into 1. Okay, now it is correct. What is the second element? Here is 0, here is 0, and plus 7 into 0 plus 0. Okay, minus 0 plus 0 cancels, no? But finally it is 0 only. What is the next one? It is 34 minus, what is 4 eights, this one, 6 eights are 48, plus 14, plus 0. Next, okay, we have 34, oh, sorry, that's over. Second row, it's 12, minus 12, plus 0, plus 0. Next entry here, it is 8, minus 24, then plus 14, plus 2. Next element is 23, minus 30, plus 7, last one is 0. Here we have 34, minus 48, plus 14, plus 0. 0, minus 0, it's only calculation part is remaining here, plus 0, then plus 0. Next one, it is 55, and then here minus 65. First one is 55, second one is minus 75, it is 78, and then plus 21 plus 2. Yeah, correct. So what do you expect here? Final answer. So obviously this will be 21 plus 9, 30. 30 minus 30, 0. So this is 0. Just observe that all elements are 0. It is 48 minus 48, 48 minus 48, 0. Just every entries will be, okay, 0 here. Just you check the remaining elements. So what this indicates, it gives you null matrix. Therefore, we have left-hand side is equal to right-hand side. Okay, so that is a proof. But normally, just okay, comparing with any other questions, this type of questions will take little time because it is calculation based. As I told, there are a few more problems based on matrix operation of this type. You please practice at home. Okay, so then, dear friends, we'll continue with one application level problem, okay? One application level problem, which is found in exercise of NCERT book. The problem is like this. A trust fund has rupees 30,000 that must be invested in two different types of bonds. The first bond pays 5% interest per year, and the second bond pays 7% interest per year. Using matrix multiplication, the question is asked like this. Using matrix multiplication, determine how to divide that 30,000 among two types of bonds. If the trust must obtain the annual total interest of, I don't write that complete question, you might have heard, just okay, it is there in the NCERT book as it is. And the question is, if the if the trust fund must be obtained with the annual total interest of 1,800 or 2,000. There are two types of this one. A, 1,800, and the second one, B, 2,000. The annual total interest, if it is 1,800 or 2,000, how you need to divide those two types of bonds? What is the total fund to be invested here? The total fund which has been given, it is 30,000. It is given that there is a 30,000 to be invested in two different types of bonds. The first bond pays 5% and the second type of bond pays 7%. There is a difference. You have to calculate in what way these are to be divided. In order to get the total interest is 1,800. See, whenever you just don't know about a particular value, you have to make use of variables. Therefore, let me begin like this. Let amount invested in first type of bond which is unknown, I call this BX. Now, can you tell me what is the second type of bond? What is the amount to be invested in second type of bond? Because total amount which is there, it is 30,000. Since X rupees is invested in first type of bond, then clearly 30,000 minus X, it should be the amount invested in second type of bond. So let me take here matrix, let me name the two matrices. One is A, the other with B. I take A is a row matrix with the one row and two columns. X, 30,000 minus X. This is a matrix which represents the investment in two types of bonds. Let me take another matrix B with the annual interest. First type of bond, it pays 5%, 5%, 5/100% means. Second type of bond, 7%. It is a 2x1 matrix. The total just interest which has to be obtained, it is obtained by evaluating x is equal to a into b. Multiplying these two matrices, we get a total amount, the total interest which you get. X is a into b. What is a? A is nothing but, it is x, 30,000 minus x. B, it is 5/100 and 7/100. Even you can take here 0.05, 0.07, no problem. And you know how to multiply the two matrices. Multiply rows of the first matrix with the columns of second matrix. Since we have the order of the first matrix, order of the first matrix, it is 1x2, and here it is 2x1. The total, the resultant matrix will be 1x1. Therefore, there should be only one entry. Therefore, you expect the resultant matrix is of order, the order of the resultant matrix will be x into 5/100, it is 5x/100. Then we have plus second element into this one, it is 7/100 into 30,000 minus x. Clearly, this particular expression gives you the total interest rate. The total interest is given like this. Okay, let me take x once again is equal to, simplify this one. We have 5x/100 minus 7x/100, it is minus, I take a matrix, 2x/100. Then we have, what is, okay, here, 30,000, I did the mistake here, 30,000 divided by 100 means two zeros get cancelled. It is 300 into 7, it will be 2,100. 2,100. And this will be the total interest. I can even write this one as, actually, 2/100 means it is minus x/50 plus 2,100. Now just let me begin with the first question. We expect the total interest is 1,800 means, for the first question we have total interest is x divided by 50 plus 2,100 should be equal to 1,800. Simplifying this one, you carry this to the other side, which gives actually, carry this 1,800 to this side, do you get 3,000? Sorry, 300 rupees, and carrying it to the other side, we get here x/50. Cross multiply, what do you get on cross multiplying? X is equal to 15 and 3 zeros. Means the value for x, it is 15,000. The investment in first type of bond is 15,000. Of course, for second type also, remaining 15,000. They are equally divided. Next, second, question number B. Suppose if the total interest expected to be 2,000. I'll make use of the same relation, like I'll just use the same relation. It is minus x divided by 50 plus 2,100. Should be equal to 2,000. Cross multiply. We expect here 2,100 minus 2,000, it is 100, is equal to x divided by 50. So which further implies, cross multiplying, x is equal to 5,000. When x is equal to 5,000, we can write, that other type of bond, 30,000 minus 5,000, it is 25,000. First type of bond, 5,000. Second type of bond, 25,000. And previous question, the solution is 15,000 each. So that is how you can answer the question. I hope all of you understood it properly. So let me continue with another application level problem, which is found in exercise. Finding the total, selling amount of books, okay? So I just read out that, I will dictate that problem which has been found in the book. As far as my memory is concerned, the question was asked like this. A bookshop of a particular school has 10 dozens of chemistry books, 8 dozens of physics books, and 10 dozens of economics books. Their selling price, rupees 80, rupees 60, and rupees 40 respectively. Means 80 for first type of chemistry, and 40 rupees for 60 rupees for physics books, and 40 rupees for economics books. Find the total amount of total amount the bookshop will receive from selling all the books using matrix algebra. Using matrix algebra, we need to calculate the total amount which he receives by selling out all the books. Actually, books are given in dozens. All of you are aware of the meaning of dozen. One dozen means 12 units. One dozen means 12 units. Okay, just I'll repeat once again. Books in dozen gets given. Let me take the total number of books which are available in the bookshop. I just treat that as a matrix A. As I've already mentioned, there are 10 dozens of chemistry books. That means 10 dozen means, okay, all of you understand, that's 10 into 12 chemistry books. 120 chemistry books are available. Then we have 8 dozens of physics books. It is 8 into 12. 8 into 12 is 96 physics books are available. Then, okay, what do you expect? Once again, 10 dozens of economics books. Therefore, it's 10 into 12, 120. Therefore, let me write the matrix A as 120, 96, 120. Order of this matrix, I take 1 cross. Let me write a matrix B, which gives the cost in rupees. First, chemistry books. Chemistry book cost, I've already mentioned, the chemistry book cost 80 rupees. Physics books, 60 rupees. And economics books, 40 rupees. Its order should be taken as 3 cross 1. You see, just selling these books with this particular amount, we get a total amount. The total amount, a single data should be obtained. Therefore, that order of the first matrix must be 1 cross 3. Order of second matrix is 3 cross 1. And the total amount, I call X, it is A into B. Order of this matrix, first matrix, it is 1 cross 3. Second matrix, 3 cross 1. 3, 3 equal. Resultant matrix is 1 cross 1, single element. Just let me evaluate this. First, okay, let me write A. It is 120, 96, 120. This into B, 80, 60, 40. So multiplying the rows of first matrix with the columns of second matrix. We have, what is 120 into 80? What is 120 into 80? Would you please do the calculation? 12 into 8, it is 96, and there are 2 zeros. Am I right? And then, okay, just we have a second one. It is 96 into 60. You can use calculator. In board examination, you can use calculator, no problem. I remember the answer. The answer should be 5,760, I hope. And then, okay, just 40 into 12, it is 48. So just what do you expect here? 4,800. We need to sum them, add them. What do you get? Adding, so the last unit place will be 0. Here it will be 6. And 5 plus 6 plus just that will be what totally? 20,160 rupees. 20,160 rupees. So this will be the total amount received by to the shopkeeper. So this is one of the problems. There are a lot of other problems, simple problems which are similar to what we have discussed today. So I request you to go through it and just please prepare yourself for even competitive examination. With the basic knowledge, you can learn a lot of things. Okay, just please practice yourself. Do not waste your time. So with this, we'll wind up and we'll meet in the next session. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.